been off of CDs and videos and movies and onto the front page as gangster rappers themselves begin to play leading roles in real-life crime dramas. But only one rapper is currently doing hard time. The irony? He is not a gangster rapper. There he is, Slick Rick, behind bars.
It is really ironic that Mickey D is the one who's in jail for a serious length of time, when in fact a lot of other artists, have been through, talk about, and are part of a more rough lifestyle and are more threatening in a lot of ways, in every way, than Mickey.
It may cause concern, it's boring. Why don't you listen and learn?
Love happy.
That once was strong,
but you too,
even that's turned wrong.
Times have changed.
Hey, it's cool to look bummy and be a dumb dummy and disrespect your mommy.
Have you forgotten?
Who put you on this earth, huh?
Who put you on proud?
And who loved you since your birth?
Slick Rick was a star from the moment he first emerged from the Bronx as MC Ricky D on Dougie Fresh's The Show, you know, Lottie Dottie, in 1985.
The show was an idea that I had that I got from a dream. And Lottie Dottie, once we did that routine, we was just taking rap contests throughout the city.
Lottie Dottie, we like the party. We don't cause trouble. We don't bother nobody. We're just some men that's on the mic. And when we rock up on the mic, we rock the mic.
The first time I heard something from Slick Rick, I was young. I was in my early teens. The song that I heard, it was Lottie Dottie, you know what I'm saying? It was like, he was totally different than anybody else that was rapping.
I'd have to say, when I thought I heard it all, and I am considered one of the pioneers, there was this gentleman that had a sound, a style, unlike anything I ever heard before. There's the MC, the rapper that just rants and talks. Then there are a handful of rappers that can lyricize and paint a picture of what they're talking about.
He probably is, to this genre of music, probably what Langston Hughes was to modern day poetry, to what Zora Neale was to poetry. People will be listening to his records forever.
Me at last, the Rickster, Def Jam's where I be at, most agree, it's kinda amazing, folks are born from where we pee at, though I definitely feel it, baby, no way, chills, clever meaning, bean, got to be carefully told.
Rick really came into his own with the release on Def Jam late in 1988 of The Great Adventures of Slick Rick.
He goes down to hip-hop as one of the greatest storytellers of all time. You know, artists nowadays still listen to his music to gain inspiration. I mean, his first album is still played in the cars all over New York City, like it just came out, you know, last month.
Because righteous laws are overdue, and this is a message that the ruler Rick threw, and it's true.
We went into Chung King Studios in New York City, and Rick got in, you know, the vocal booth. He said, yeah, turn out all the lights. And I was like, yeah, you know, that's pretty normal. A lot of people like to turn out all the lights. Then all of a sudden, he started moving things around the room, and he built like this little... It reminded me like a standing casket in a sense, but he put like a whole bunch of blankets over it, and it was real dark, right? And he's like, all right, I'm ready to go. And before we even started, we heard a whole bunch of little voices coming out there, like little kids, and then like a woman's voice, and we're like, you know, we didn't know what was going on.
Led by the success of its first single, Children's Story, Great Adventures took off like a bullet on its way to sales of over 1.5 million copies. Hailed as perhaps the greatest writer and storyteller in the history of rap, Rick toured arenas from coast to coast and conspicuously enjoyed the rewards of his success.
He always looked good. He never wore sneakers. He was more like, you know, probably like, more like what Houdini is, you know, a real clean-cut rapper. 100% style, and the jewelry just really tied it all together. It was about, you know, I'm richer than everybody else. This is how I'm spending my money. I'm living like a king, even if he wasn't. He just gave the image that he was. And that's really all rap is anyway. It's about, you know, the image of greatness.
Even the image of greatness has its price. Like the hapless hero of Children's Story, Rick suddenly got embroiled in real trouble. A gang of young men riddled his Jeep with bullets one night in April of 1990 when Rick was out on the town. Convinced that he knew the perpetrators and anxious to protect himself, Rick shot at the suspected ringleader a few weeks later. He missed his man but hit an innocent bystander, led the police on a wild chase, and ended crashing his car. Charged with 5 felonies, Rick was convicted of attempted murder and sentenced to 3 1/3 to 10 years behind bars.
He had a rough crew around him, and he had, you know, the same things a lot of artists have, and I think maybe we could have done more, and I don't think there were any real signs that he was, going to get into trouble. I mean, it's not like he was a drug addict, so we really could have maybe been there, but I don't know if, you know, if I can blame us or anybody, because what happened was a coincidence, and it happened quickly.
See, a lot of brothers in jail that's bitter, you know what I'm saying? But if their bitterness ain't gonna make nothing, it's gonna make they bit harder, you know what I'm saying? They just gotta accept it and just go with the flow, and you know what I'm saying? Sooner or later they get out. Do your time, go home to your family, and be productive.
Well, I tried to block it out my mind, here it was again. Other men confronted later and she said he was a friend. Didn't believe her, she packed. Brave her, strange behavior, so silly we forget.
Out on parole in the spring of 1991, Rick went right back to work. The Ruler's Back was released midway through 1991 after he'd begun doing hard time.
She like, oh, come here, let me smell you. I wanted to say, the hell you hide.
Just shot. A lot of MCs came to my showdown and watched me put the low down.
Recording many of the tracks that would appear on Behind Bars.
We got them joints almost exactly like you made them. You know, like sitting in my car, because the kids is already playing it. They found, I don't even know how they got it. It seemed like over the last 2 or 3 years, and over the last year especially, the whole street got to really understand and appreciate even more what you did. So they're giving you love in the street right now.
Behind Bars.
Slick, I know your mind ain't trapped, son. Word up, man. I know you in there doing it right, baby. Be safe and be strong. Word is born.
I wait 100 years for you to get out. When you get out, man, I want to see you get busy, baby, because you got it going on.
I be a bigger star than you, though, never heard it.
We love you, Slick Rick. See you when you get home. The ghetto loves you, baby.
Word up. This is to my man, Slick Rick. Word up. This is the funk doctor spot red, man, in y'all mouths. Hey, yo, I'm giving big props to my man Slick Rick. He need to come out of jail. Word up, that's no place for MC to be thinking.
The influence he still got on me is that he in a situation where people think that his head should be down, but he still got his head up. No matter what they do to him, they can never hold him down.
How's prison changed you?
You appreciate your freedom a lot more, you know, the little things. You don't be so materialistic. Appreciate family life, all that good stuff, you know?
Unfortunately, Rick has not been able to convince the New York State Parole Board that he has paid his debt to society and now deserves his freedom, even though he has already served the minimum amount of time on a sentence. He is currently leading the legal efforts to get himself out of jail.
You'll be home soon, man. I hope this appeal works out.
All right, thanks a lot.
God bless you, guys.
You too.
Pushing for the drawers. Under pressure while exchanging glances, Dawn finally gives into the sexual.